Hey, what's going on, guys? It is Alex here with the next part of our playthrough of Alan Wake American Nightmare. We are looped for the third time through these events, I guess. Eventually, I assume we get through the loop. I don't know how. So we're gonna figure it out. Oh. This is new. All right, that was supposed to be a boss fight, I guess. Oh, there's a manuscript page here. There was definitely not one here before, so there's going to be pages in different places now. We are not reading the manuscript pages anymore. I don't find them as intriguing as I did in the first game, and I'd really like to get through this game because in about 4 hours from now, Alan Wake 2 comes out. And I want to play the first hour or two and start uploading videos tonight so that I can trickle those out tomorrow while I'm working, and then I can continue to put them out after work.
Right on cue, bubbling to the surface from untold depths, the horrors come. The emerging monsters do not expect the warm reception that has already been prepared for them.
Oh, it's all done. Everything's in its place. Okay. Zap. Shroom. And radio. Satellite, boom. At some point, I feel like something's got to break the cycle, right? And I feel like it's got to be the satellite thing. Because that's the most recognizable part of whatever we've been doing. Solid music. Hoping it's not copyrighted, but if it is, it doesn't matter, because I don't make money off any of this anyway. Yeah. The gunplay in this is definitely, or the, just the combat in general is more fluid in this game, but they didn't increase the,
next stop, saving Emma.
They didn't increase the difficulty of the enemies to account for my side of this being more fluid. Like, the enemies still feel as weak as they always did. Or as weak as they did in the last game, but it feels like they've given me significantly better weaponry to deal with them. Alright, let's grab some... Oh, I don't need, actually. I don't need this submachine gun ammo. Because I already have ammo. A little bit. Maybe I'm just a god gamer. Maybe things haven't gotten easier. I'm just really good.
Yeah.
That could be it.
Thanks for saving me again. I'd hate to die before I'm scheduled to be murdered.
I guess I have you to thank for setting everything up at the oil derrick.
Yeah, well, I figured that if we were going to go over this again, we might as well try to be smart about it, huh?
I appreciate it. You took a big chance doing that. Are you okay?
What do you think? I've died twice. I remember everything pretty clearly now. You said I was gonna be okay.
I don't know what happened.
Well, it's not your fault. I think one of those, what did you call them? The takers? I think they did something to the power and they got me that way.
I'm sorry.
But I got the keys from the dead guy in that room. And I'm not handing them over until you do something about this. I'm sick of getting killed.
What if I just kill her for them? Bang, keys, done.
You seem calmer now.
I tried freaking out. Didn't do much good for me. I guess you get used to the craziest stuff.
Oh, the fuse box is probably in here, isn't it?
Unless I figured I'd take the edge off.
Of course not. No.
Those herbal supplements are pretty good.
Other way around.
Oh, yeah.
Can I scoop-a-doop the page over here real quick? I don't mind going out of my way for them now that I know I'm not, like, sticking around, like, reading all of them. I just want them to be able to unlock the new weaponry that we find. Oh, stupid. Good use of a flashbang, I think. Was that not on to begin with? Alrighty then. I know this is the long way around. I'm just peeking my head around. Oh, no, it's not. It's actually the short way around. Well, look at that.
Okay. I really don't think they can get to the power now.
Thank you. That's a relief. Here's the keys that you needed.
Thank you.
Hey, I have to tell you, at the diner, I went there with him. The guy who looks like you, okay? I know I said that I didn't.
Yeah, I figured. Want to talk about what happened at the diner?
There was this guy from the observatory, and he just attacked the poor dude, smashed his face into the tabletop a bunch of times. It was horrible. I didn't know.
I don't actually care what she has to say. Not that I don't respect the strong women in my video games. I respect and appreciate them so much. But Mr. Scratch, I mean, I know he's apparently the villain of the next game. That's just like something I've figured out at this point by watching the trailer. But it's the room with the dead guy. But the key, I thought she said she got the keys already. Did she lie to me? Did I not listen to her say she was lying to me? All right, we're going to open this one other room up real quick. Just, check what's in this other room that it was leading me towards. I think this is the one I got the manuscript page from, so it doesn't actually matter. But we're just going to be sure. Plus flare gun ammo. I need that for the, drive-in. There is, however, a manuscript page back here that we'll go grab. Because once we get 30, we get whatever that weapon is in. I think it's the sawed-off shotgun. And not that I want to use it or anything, but I want to use it. Sawed-off shotgun? Oh boy, if I had one of those when I was in high school, I would have done nothing with it, because what would I have done? Shot things in my backyard?
Individuals hangs in the balance, threatened by the machinations of the Herald of Darkness. And yet, for a moment, the Champion of Light breathes a little easier. He has saved one life. For this moment, it is enough. And soon, perhaps, he can put an end to this.
What if Mr. Scratch is just mad because he's got this itch on his back he can't reach, and I just need to scratch it for him, and that's why he's called Mr. Scratch. Once I ch-ch-ch-ch for him, he ends everything. We become best friends. He controls the darkness and turns it into a playground
for
kids.
What he hopes is the final time, the man feels anticipation and dread in equal measure. Soon, he knows he will have what he needs.
All right, so we start at the bottom here. We secure the thingies down here. Then we move up, get the key, get the three things we need. It's gonna be easy.
I've already taken care of the imaging array, but you should still look into securing the primary coolant flow. With some luck, you may be able to light the area before these things show up.
I'll secure your primary coolant. I don't entirely know what that means, but it sounded good.
Thank you.
You tried this last time, buddy. Didn't work then, won't work now. You're gonna knock the pipe down, but the pipe's gonna stay standing because it's too strong. That's what I thought, bitch. Oh, back to Dr. Meadows. Dr. Meadows is my bae. I love her. I'll do anything for her except fight more spiders. Oh, wait, guys. The bulbs have to break as we're running up the walk. Oh, boy. Safety? No. But safety up here for sure. No. I don't think this would be more fun on nightmare mode. I just think it would be more tedious, that's all. That's fun. I love that. Let me in.
Come on in.
What if by the last loop, all of my companions know what they have to do already, and I'd show up at the motel, she's like, it's all done, go to the observatory. Go to the observatory, she stops me before I get out of the car with the intercom, just like, you don't have to do anything here either, you're good to go. Is that it? Am I missing anyone? Hello? Did I kill them too quickly? Wow, I've totally forgotten to speak. I've just been jamming out to whatever this song is. It's awesome. Copyrighted or not, I'm okay with it. Maybe in the future I have to come back and mute that part of the game, but awesome. I'm all right.
I'll send the lift down to you.
How about you, ma'am?
Our previous encounters very clearly now. But technically, if this really is a loop in time, we've never met before. I don't know why our awareness persists, but it's bloody fascinating.
Wait, look at my eyes. Yeah, they look really black here. Like, all black.
Doctor?
You know, I know physicists who would give 15 years of their lives for a chance to experience something like this.
I'd imagine that being stalked by horrible axe murderers would curb their enthusiasm a little.
Clearly you've never met hardcore physicists.
I'm glad you're in such good spirits, but...
The signal! Yes, it's completed!
Finally.
In a strange way, he feels at ease. He is armed with his own words, and when the time comes, They will be enough, or they will not. For now, he's content to let the currents take him toward the final confrontation.
Drive-in. I've never been to a drive-in theater. I've had many opportunities I could have gone
once
to one,
more,
but
we return to the
never.
If he's aware of the absurdity of arming oneself with a few sentences and standing against a power that can pierce time itself, he doesn't show it. The man has his share of weaknesses, perhaps more, but cowardice is not among them.
Why do I start back here?
Oh, you got yourself a little plan, do you?
I'm gonna win this game without dying once. That is my new goal. If I die a single time, I'm gonna be very upset with myself, because there is zero reason to die in this game. I've been hearing phenomenal things about Alan Wake 2. I'm so excited to play it tomorrow. You don't even know. Well, tonight, I guess, but technically tomorrow. Oh my gosh. Like, everyone is saying it has no right being as good as it is. Which may be exaggeration, because sometimes that happens in when games are coming out. They get, you know, the early reviews by the big companies are kind of a little paid for and whatnot, but I don't know. These feel pretty genuine. Oh. Okay. Feel like Obi-Wan standing behind the force field watching Qui-Gon die. Just having to wait. Alright, guys. Think we're good, right? Yeah, it feels good to me. Wait. I'm going straight to the projector building. I'm not stopping to save the girl this time. That's an alpha move, Alan. Alpha move. Who needs that girl?
You're never getting out of this, Wake. Never! Don't worry. I'll take care of your wife and your life.
That's the closest we've come to dying this whole time. That one hit by that one guy took us down to, I think it was, almost no health at all. Get the ammo. I could go grab the sawed off. I think I'm at 30 at this point. But, like, do I waste the time or do I just go, you know? Oh! I didn't realize what that was. I didn't mean to shoot that. That was unintended.
it is you're gonna do is gonna make a difference, this'll end up just like before.
Then why are you trying to stop me so hard, Mr. Scratch? If nothing I could possibly do is gonna change anything, why not just let me run my little loop for the rest of my life? Over and 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 over until I'm just eventually killed by your minions. What's your obsession with stopping me? Even shoot them this time. Oh wait, that one, Jesus. Are there four dark fountains this time? Seems like it. Bring me the fourth. I bet he shows up inside the projector booth this time and he's just begging me, like, now hold on. We can talk this through. Don't be hasty. I'm a part of you. Why would you want to get rid of me? Because he knows I'm about to do it.
Again, the champion of light enters the final trap. The new reality is almost here. All he needs to do is change the details of the scene, push it past the breaking point, and the rest will snap into place.
This goes to August. This goes to 2:36 a.m. This gets flipped around to noir. This becomes that, and then we have two more, or one more. Alice's film was in the projector. Alice is real. Oh, this had to get it twice, because it needs to go over on the fire extinguisher. And lastly, we replace the film, which I have to do from this side, I guess. Oh. I want to watch Alice's film. My wife made a movie, goddammit! I'm going to watch that movie!
Oh, come on, buddy. Why don't you... What? What is this? No! No! You can't do this! All I did was take the things you always wanted and never had the balls to go for! It's my turn now! It's my life!
Ooh, let's see Alice. Real life Alice. What's up?
Is it really you?
It's really me.
How? I love you.
I
love you. Ooh! Get it! Yeah.
A woman. A man.
Split down the middle. Game's not over.
Held apart for far too long. Enveloped in the light of a glorious dawn. They both feel it. He's home at last. Are these actual events, or merely a dream, a memory, or a glimpse of what is to come? One thing is certain. This scene takes place in another time and another place, far, far away from Night Springs.
Listen, that was not its own game. That, as a DLC to the original Alan Wake, would have been fine. 10, 15 bucks, fine. A three and a half hour experience, depending on what you're doing, great. No, stop. As its own game, though, what? That, like, I have to assume this didn't retail at, like, a full $60 price, because people would have rioted. That's, for what it was fine. But for what it was supposed to be, which is like the sequel to Alan Wake, like a shoot-off of Alan Wake, it just felt wrong. The combat was more fun, but it didn't feel true to Alan Wake. It felt like you were way too overpowered the whole time. I didn't die a single time. And the only times I came close to dying is when I was dumb and just stood still because I thought I could just blow through them, which I did. I didn't die. All the same, if you find it, if it's part of a bundle, It's worth your time if you enjoy the Alan Wake world. I'm hoping that Mr. Scratch comes back and is cooler in the second game that I'm going to play in a couple hours here. But yeah, as a full game on its own, it's like a 3.5 out of 10. If you think of it as a DLC and it's only at the time only came out for like 15 bucks, maybe it's like a 5, but it's not great. Thank you guys so much for watching, though. If you liked, if you could like, comment, subscribe, do whatever you can to help me rise up the YouTube algorithm. That way other people can find and enjoy my content. I would really appreciate it. And as always, guys, until next time, see ya.